strategy, and I'm going to be doing a cool down with you today. So this is just going to be a 5-minute cool down, and it's something for you to do every time that you do a class, and then it gives you a cool down to do afterwards. Sometimes when we do 30 minutes, we just don't have enough time to do a full cool down. So 5 minutes is about right what you need to do to actually cool down the body. Okay guys, so we're going to start just lying on our backs. So what we're going to do first is just take a little release into the spine. So we're just going to draw the knees up, hold around the knees and take a little sway from side to side. This is just a nice simple cool down, nothing fancy. And then we're going to bring the feet down. You're going to draw the right knee toward the chest and just start to work into these hips. So releasing into the hips and into that back. If you want to add more, extend through that leg. From here, we're going to have to stretch into the hamstring, the back of the leg. So if you have a strap or anything like that, you can use that, or you can just extend the leg, place the hand around the back of the leg. You can bend into that knee if it feels too much. Flexing into the foot, really feel that stretch along the back. From here, we're going to take a little stretch into the glutes, so into the bottom muscles. So we're going to bend into that knee, and then bend into this knee, placing the ankle onto the thigh. Now, you can either stay here and just press the knee away from the body here, or you can hold around the back of the leg, drawing the knee towards you. It's a little bit more of an intense stretch into those glutes. But go with what works for you. Across the thigh, so you can either press the knee away from the body, or you can bring the hands underneath and just draw the knee towards you a little bit more into those glutes there. And release, good. Bring that leg down. Draw both knees towards you, place the hands behind, take a little rock up. And we're going to come into a kneeling position. We're going to take a big stretch into those hips here now. So we're going to take the right knee forwards, the right leg forwards, making sure the knee is in line with the ankle. We're just going to lean into the hip, make sure the back knee is away from the hip. Chest coming down toward the thigh, taking the stretch here. Now we can take a nice little spinal twist here, which will release the back muscles here. So if you want to, you can add a twist in here, placing the right hand onto the right knee, and then twisting the body, taking a look up to the ceiling. If you want more, you can open into that shoulder. So really releasing the upper back too when we take that big twist here. Or you can just stay with the hand on the knee. Bringing that hand down and then just taking the stretch on the other side, bringing that knee out in line with the ankle, chest down, the other knee away from the hip. So you can either just stay here, which is great, opening into the hips, or we can take the twist as well, taking the left hand onto the left knee, twist if you want more, opening and feeling that beautiful stretch into the shoulder. Really nice for releasing these muscles here in the back too. Bringing the hand down now, bringing that knee down, we're going to stretch into your thighs, into the quadriceps. So we're going to bring the knees nice and wide. We can also get a cheeky stretch into the hips as well. So bring the knees nice and wide, toes come together, sinking back into the heels. We're going to get a nice stretch along the spine as well, and a nice stretch along the arms. So lots of muscle stretching out here. So we're going to come down, extend it through the arms, bring the head down, and feel that lovely release into those legs, into the upper body. Covers all bases, this one. Thank you.